first of all, it is a rare disease, and so most doctors have had little or no experience with it. Consequently, it's advised that if you have that diagnosis for the first time, it's best to see an expert, somebody who knows more about it. Many doctors have mistaken ideas because they've never seen it, and consequently are promulgating or practicing with the wrong concepts. With the passage of time, since it's only relatively recently elucidated condition has been described, some of the concepts that are afield are wrong. Investigations, studies which have been more frequent recently have shown more information that's been up to date and tells us that some of the original ideas were not correct. So this would be my first words of advice. Well, when you say neuroendocrine cancer, there are quite a variety of that would go under the name of neuroendocrine cancer. They're all related to carcinoid, but let's presume that we're talking about carcinoid. It is true that inhibiting hormone injection would be effective to some significant degree, not only as treating the cancer, that is inhibiting it or reversing it, as well, or slowing it down would be more correct to say, besides just reducing the symptoms. That's a great question in this particular current time because of the burgeoning popularity and success with other types of malignancies of immunotherapy. And there are ways to get an idea. First of all, there have been recent clinical trials in carcinoid with immunotherapy, which have been promising but not completely successful. So more trials with various immunologic agents are underway. And one of the things that can be done is to determine if certain features in the biopsy of the tumor tissue are present, and that will indicate the likelihood of a good response to immunotherapy. However, the results of immunotherapy of various types are not yet as good in carcinoid as they are for example, lung cancer. Well, fatigue, gallstones, diabetes, or at least elevation of the blood sugar. Some people have headache and others have cramping.
Okay. Hopefully that helps your question.
There's one other side effect that is not rare, and that's fatty diarrhea, so-called steatorrhea. Well, first of all, it helps the most to know what the cause is.
Of course.
And gas and bloating are not particularly common symptoms of carcinoid. Diarrhea is, but there are many, many things that can cause diarrhea,
sure,
including some of the medicine that's used to treat carcinoid. As I said before, Sandostatin or lanreotide can cause steatorrhea as a side effect. It's not very, very common, but it can occur. So the first thing that's necessary in before treating is to try to find out what the cause is. There are certain types of infections, certain types of illnesses, such as pancreatic insufficiency, that can cause bloating and steatorrhea. So once finding out the cause, then you can approach treatment. They don't really work differently. They both have the same effect of being attracted to the same receptor on the tumor cell. They work a little bit differently in that regard, but they're not usually often or even rarely used simultaneously. You use one or the other, and either one in a significant number of cases wears out its effectiveness over a period of time, usually about a year and a half or 2 years. However, then the use of the other drug will be effective again. Then we should switch to lanreotide, somatuline, and most of the time that will start to work again. Afinitor is everolimus, a targeted treatment which inhibits one of the tyrosine kinase enzymes that is necessary for activation of one of the growth pathways for carcinoid, and it is one of the drugs that is used with effectiveness in a significant number of cases. Well, there are different modes of treatment. Lutathera is radioisotope, which gives internal radiation of the tumors. That's PRRT. Whereas the other drugs mentioned are different forms of chemical treatment, which work to inhibit some of the enzymes necessary to facilitate the pathways for tumor growth. The chemotherapy is used in addition to PRRT. It's not clear yet whether in the course of this disease, PRRT should be the first treatment. Mm-hmm. Or whether other types of treatment come first, which is more the common practice at present.